Kyle's with TaylorMade. He's been with them for a while. I'm with Callaway at the moment. I'm trying out the new Callaway Rogue. Today's the first time I'm hitting it, and it's working out pretty good. I've been with Callaway for a year and a half, I think. It's pretty good. I like all the gear. But I think Callaway and TaylorMade are two of the top manufacturers in the business right now. So we're getting looked after really well. Hopefully we can keep it for the relationship longer.
All right, so here we got a 487 meter par 5. That's 535 yards. And I guess it just bombs away down the middle.
Just staying down the left edge. Will it stay on the fairway?
That was hit off the heel. Started way left of where I was trying to hit it, so.
You're just saying that because I'm about to out drive him.
Oh, four left.
So Lexi Thompson's brother is on the verge of the PGA Tour.
Yeah.
So you could be the first brother and sister siblings to both be playing on the main tours.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that would be pretty cool. We've had a few achievements as a brother and sister, like winning the US Junior. She won the girls in, I think, 2012. That's pretty cool. Brother and sister thing, it's pretty awesome to, I guess, have a sister that's really good at golf. I guess if I follow up, achievements will come, and hopefully we get plenty of achievements, and it's just fun. It's just fun having a sister that's good. I guess having her as a best friend too, it's pretty cool.
I've driven it left in the bush. I have a punch draw shot. It's not too bad, so that's a shot I'm going to hit. Hopefully I hit it good enough to get it front edge or on the green. There it goes. Pretty good. Could be in the bunker, maybe short of it.
I'm good friends with all the Kangaroos. They come up to me and give me a fist pump now and then, so we're pretty cruisy friendship going on here. I'll just tell the Americans, they don't come up to you and box you. They're pretty friendly.
There's no such thing as a drop bear.
Yeah, there's no such, no, there is, no, no, there isn't. I guess if you go near them, they just run away. They're not harmful. They're just like Australian. It's just good to see kangaroos on the course.
Like deer.
Yeah, it's just cool to have. Not many courses in Australia have them. So yeah, when there's a course that has kangaroos, it's pretty cool.
I have 225. Goal is just a little left of the pin. I'm gonna hit a nice five. Get it back there.
Coming back nice.
Get up, get up.
That'll be the right club.
Ooh. He's in the bunker.
Didn't come back with the draw, but it's in the bunker, it's fine.
I'll go in.
Ooh.
That was pretty slick.
Carl's gonna play his here. Yeah.
Not bad.
I think there was a bit of mud on his ball, so he kind of rolled out, but
Yeah, I like big markers.
Yeah. Yeah.
So Minwu to take a one hole lead. Yep, straight down the guts.
One up.
Five through four. Green back.
In a while, so.
Right. Now, you know, guys at your level, obviously, on your day, you're world beaters, and Minwu, you won the US Junior Am, was it last year, the year before last?
Year before, yes, 2016, yeah.
So, yeah, you're at the very top of the tree in junior golf.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have tournaments that just don't really go your way, and this week you both probably would have liked to have done better at the Australian Amateur. Yeah. But a lot of kids watching this are going to want to know, well, how do you bounce back from a bad tournament? Like, well, not a bad tournament, but a tournament where you would have liked to have gone deeper.
Australian Amateur, it's a big event in Australia, probably one of the biggest, and you definitely want to play well. There was a bit of pressure there, being one of the favourites, but I lost pretty early, round 32, but my mindset is to go into the next tournament thinking you're going to win. The good thing about golf, you have a tournament nearly every week or every month, so in a couple of weeks or in a week, you'll forget about this tournament that you've played and move on to the next, and we all know that we got bigger, better things to look forward to, so always go in with a mindset that you can win the next tournament. And if you are having a bad stretch, it doesn't really matter. I think for the Australian Amateur, for the first 3 years, I missed the cut. I lost in a playoff in my third year to get into the top 64, and then the next year I nearly won, so came second last year. You just have to move on, but never look on it too much. You just have to move on and keep it going.
And going on a bit with what you just said, it sounds like it's also a good reason to play tournaments more frequently, so that if you do have a bad one, that you don't have to mull over that bad result for too long before. It's basically like when you fall off a horse, the first thing you've got to do is hop straight back in the saddle. What are your thoughts about playing frequently?
I think you should definitely have a schedule to go off. I've talked to a lot of pros, and they said 3 or 4 is their max, like weeks in a row they can go until they feel too tired to play the fifth week or the fourth week. So I think you need to play moderately, but obviously if it's a big tournament and a big stretch of months that you have to play, you have to prepare well for it, and you got to play. Yeah, you just have to play them. And but I think everyone's different. Some people can play 6 weeks in a row, some people can only play 2 weeks in a row. So I think you need to know for yourself, which we both are. We're traveling the world and playing all these tournaments. So we're getting to a stage where we know how many tournaments we can hold.
Okay, it's probably about, it's 285 meters from 10 yards forward. So I think it's about
335.
Yeah, it's about 335, like you said. It's playing into the wind, it's playing a little downhill, so I think a good hit will probably get there for both of us. Draw. It's pretty good, probably front edge or maybe on the green.
What is that?
How do you hit that shot?
I don't know.
Carl's got some kangaroos in the way of his shot here. You aren't going to hit him. Alright, so, oh, here we go. Little Joey hopping into its mum's pouch. Yeah, oh, trying to hop in. Lord knows how you fit a square peg into a round hole. Oh, it's actually having breakfast.
I gotta like YOLO this shot, anyways.
Oh, that's a good shot.
It's over.
Yeah.
Alright, let's check on the jump in.
Oh, no, it didn't.
Kangaroo, Joey.
Well, Carl's got a chance to harve if you can get up and down here. There's putting's again been letting him down. It's a good looking putt. Good looking putt. Yeah.
Bro, how good is River
Alright, midway for his birdie and to go three up.